What is going on, everybody? Today I'm going over JMIA stock, ticker symbol JMII. And if you guys are new to my channel, I go over financial statements of stocks so you don't have to. I'm reading the financials and I'm trying to find the fair value of each and every stock. If you like what you see, subscribe to my channel. My name is Finance After 40, and with that being said, let's get started with analyzing JMIA stock's financials. Let's go. Before we go over the numbers of JMIA stock, let me tell you that I am bullish on JMIA stock. I'm gonna tell you exactly why at the end. Let's get started with JMIA. First, what do we got? Yahoo Finance, price today 27, down a lot. The last 6 months, all growth stocks got hammered. And some people call stock market a scam, and other people, hint, think that this is a buying opportunity, not a financial advice. Let's see what we got. 52 week range, $4 all the way to 70. So we didn't get it at $4, but we also didn't get it at 70. We're down to 27, pretty awesome. And this fits my category for you guys that know what I'm looking for. I'm looking for companies have a market cap between $1 and $10 billion that has the potential to become $100 billion market cap in the future. And if that happens, this will put it in about, let's say, 40x your money from here. So if you invest, I don't know, $10,000, that's a life-changing money. Not anymore, but still, that's $400,000. It is life-changing money for a lot of people. You can buy a house cash, even though Graham Stefan doesn't think it's a good idea. I do think it's a good idea to buy a house cash, but that's just me. With that being said, this is a good potential. I like it a lot better at 27 than at 70 bucks. Let's go over some numbers and see what we got. I'm in the financial tab right here. I got three items: income statement, balance sheet, cash flow. Let's go over one by one on major stuff so you guys can see how to read financials. It's not scary. See what I'm looking for. First thing I'm looking for in the income statement, the first item, is total revenue. And at a glance, I want to see that it's growing. So what do we have here? We got, let's go all the way to 2018, 130 million, 160 million, that's good. Back to 140 million in 2020, no surprise there, 2020 was 2020. And the last 12 months, 137. So from like May till May 2020 to 2021. So we saw growth, 130, 160, then pandemic, and they're trying to get back into business, and that's why you saw the price plunging more than 50%. It's like 60 plus percent now, from 70 bucks to 27. That's good. Market cap of less than $3 billion is good. Let's see how much they're making. I know they're not making a lot in here. 140 negative, okay? I'm gonna start with the net and I'm gonna go to the gross. So the net income, again, while it is super growth company and it is negative, I wanna see some sort of improvement. That's all I'm looking for hyper growth companies, new companies that could be the next Amazon for the specific region of Africa, I don't know, 10 years from now. So let's see here, diluted net income. I'm gonna start here again. 2018, we got negative 170 million. A year later, negative 226. That's not good. And look at this, 2020, they improved their net income margin to 160. And so far in the last 12 months, from May till May, we are now at 140, which is the best number from all those last 3 years. 170, worse 230, better at 160, and now we are negative 140. It's not gonna be a positive stock now. You're not gonna make insane return in the next year. But again, if I'm buying stocks at this range, the $1 to $10 billion market cap, that have a $100 billion potential, I don't expect it to be profitable in the next, I don't know, at least 3 to 5 years minimum. 3 years. So if you do the calculation, they went from 220 to 160. So let's assume the same ratio. Let's assume the same ratio, that 60 million. By the end of this year, it would be negative 100. By the end of 2022, let's say it's negative 30, 40. And by the end of 2023, they should be, you know, give or take, maybe make a dollar profit, something like that. So you have like 2 years to start a position if you believe that this company could go there. And of course, the stock market always foresee the future. So by the time they are profitable, most likely they will be above the 70 bucks and most likely a lot higher. Just my opinion. And if I look at the gross profit, again, I want this to grow. I want the net to go to zero, from the negative high to zero. But in the gross profit, I want to grow. And it does. Look at this. 45 million, 75 million, 92 million, 94. So all in all, in the income statement, I really like what I see with JMIA stock. Let's move on to the balance sheet. Yeah. Okay, in the balance sheet, again, I'm looking for growth. First of all, total assets, I want to see that it's growing. Let's start with 2018, because that's what we did in the income statement. 142 million, a year later, 300 million, double than that. Made in 2020, 355 million. So still in 2020, look at this, in 2020, with everything that happened, but Amazon were super profitable, and it looks like JMIA were super profitable as well in their region. They're still growing, still growing. Let's see if they took any bad debt. Let's see what happened here. I'm looking for this one. Total non-current liabilities, long-term debt right here. No, they took 8 million and here 6 million. So they're growing. You can't expect them to be perfect right now. Maybe if Amazon took, I don't know, like 8 years to become profitable. So they are looking to become profitable 3 years down the line, give or take. So that's good. That's pretty good, especially they were here in about 4 years at least. So it's the same path. I mean, it's not going to be the next Amazon, but if I can take a company, buy a company at like 3 billion, and there's a potential for 100 billion for 40 times my money. What's wrong with that? Nothing. Let's move on to the cash flow. See what we got. I'm in the cash flow, and this is the only not good number that I see. Issue of capital stock. So what they have done in 2020, they took 200 million, issue more stocks, so there's more shares available in the market. So theoretically, there's more supply, price goes down. And in the last 12 months, from May till May, they doubled it. So there's double the amount of shares available. Yes, the price is the same, but there's double the shares. And this is what caused the drop. Why did they do it? To raise capital. Based on what? Based on a retail trader pumping this stock to like 60, 70 bucks. I would sell the same thing because they need money for infrastructure, for doing everything that they're trying to accomplish in that specific region of Africa. That's the key here. So while they, and that's why they went down 50-60%. Don't think it's because, I don't know, because Reddit lied to you or whatever the case, or TikTok told you to buy JMIA at 60. And now it's you're down 50% and you call the stock market a scam. It's not the case. The only reason, not the only reason, but the major reason why it dropped 50%, because now there's double the shares. Double the shares mean that this is worth 54, but it's not 54, it's 27, because there's double the share price. And just think, it was almost 70 before the delusion. Just show you how crazy retail traders can push and push prices no matter logic or value. And that's a good thing if we are in this train. Just remember to don't get left holding the bag. But I like JMIA as of today at those prices. Let's see what else we got. Negative cash flow, 90 million compared to 100 million compared to 188 million. So yeah, they're going there. They're going there. I'll give them 3 to 5 years to become positive, net income, positive cash flow. in that time frame, the 3 to 5 years, that's the time to accumulate and start and accumulate a position if you believe in what they're doing and if they can do what they want to do. Let's go on with my conclusion, guys. Yeah, why I'm bullish on JMIA stock. Just go to the website and read this. Our achievement: 1.2 billion consumers and 17 million small medium enterprises to serve across Africa. 1.2 billion people, okay? 1.2 billion people and 17 million businesses. Over 1 billion visited our marketplace just in 2019. One transaction or a lead every 2 seconds. Does this remind you of Amazon? It does to me. Okay, that's very important key part. 110,000 active sellers on the platform. Does this remind you of Amazon as well? It does to me. Over 40 million products, restaurants, and other services. So they're not just doing the Amazon, they're doing deliveries and other cool stuff. Let me show you one more thing. What we do, well, you can read, more than 110,000 local African companies did business on JMIA in 2019, taking the African economies online, enabling our sellers to reach and better serve more customers. And you can read all about this stock. I'm very bullish. And let me tell you my conclusion. I think that because I missed Amazon, I didn't miss Amazon. I wasn't like an investor 20 years ago. We all missed Amazon, let's be real. We if you buy now at like a $1.5 trillion market cap, you're not gonna make 30-40 times your money. It's not gonna happen on Amazon. It's safe. 20 years ago it wasn't safe. I missed on Amazon, most of you did the same, and most importantly, I missed on Meli, Mercalibre, which is like eBay for South America. I saw Mercalibre at like $20 10 years ago. It's like almost $2,000 now. That's almost 100x. I'm sure it was 100x like 6 months ago. I missed on that as well. JMIA is trying to be what Amazon is for USA, what is Mercalibre for South America. JMIA is trying to do that with the Africa country region. That's the key here. And for that option, yes, it's risky, yes, everything, but we got a better price now, 60% discount than what it was a couple of months ago. And that's the key. Retail trader pushed it away, and then retail trader went to crypto. Everything dried out in growth stocks. It doesn't mean the company just went away. That meant the share price gave you now 50-60% discount. I am super bullish on JMIA, not a financial advice. If you like what you see, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell, all that good stuff. Thank you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Yep.